Have you ever wanted to play an 80s action movie? Well, you can, sort of, with Black. Black is a first-person shooter from 2006 that was released on the Xbox and PlayStation 2. I played it on the PlayStation 2. I played it on the easy difficulty mode. This means I only had to do the main objectives and there were more health packs scattered around the levels. It took me about 6 hours to complete the story mode. There are 4 difficulty modes, Easy, Normal, Hard and Black Ops. Black Ops is only unlocked once you beat the game on the hard difficulty. There are 8 missions, each taking about 25 minutes to complete. The missions remind me a lot of the Call of Duty games. For instance, the second level was kind of a stealth level, though stealth doesn't really work in this game. Let me explain. If you fail to kill an enemy in one shot, he and all the other enemies around him will be alerted. So unless you're a headshot god, you will probably be detected. It is better to go full rampage and kill everyone, which is also way more fun to do. But back to the similarities with Call of Duty. The second mission, the stealth mission, reminded me a lot of the ultimatum mission in Call of Duty 4 Modern Warfare. And there are more of those moments that seemed familiar to me. The seventh mission takes place on a bridge, which reminded me of the special ops mission Suspension from Modern Warfare 2. One part of mission 3 takes place in a room, which reminded me of the Gulag in Modern Warfare 2. So I don't know if Call of Duty based some of their missions on the missions from Black, but there seem to be a lot of similarities. There are a lot of things in this game that can explode. Cars, buildings, windows, you name it. This makes the levels a lot more interactive and fun to play through, because you're always wondering what is going to explode next or what you can blow up. Though the explosions make the game exciting to play, graphic-wise it isn't that good. I mean, don't get me wrong, for a 2006 game it is really good, but it's just really brown-grayish, which makes it less appealing to look at. But at least each mission is unique in its design, making them feel less repetitive to play through.
Destroy a steel plant being used as a weapons factory. Division figured if we couldn't cut off Seventh Wave's head, then the next best thing was to disrupt their operations. It was deemed too dangerous. Too politically volatile for a regular strike.
The story in this game really sucks, if you can even call it a game. You play as a soldier named Keller. The game starts with a cutscene where Keller is interrogated. At the beginning of each mission, interrogation cutscenes are shown. In the cutscenes they try to be super serious and realistic, but this contradicts with the actual gameplay, which is all about having fun, which is just like an 80s action movie. Each mission you play took place before the interrogation, so it's kind of like the campaign of Call of Duty Black Ops. Difference is that the game actually had an interesting story. Because I found the story so uninteresting, I found it hard to actually follow the story. All I know is that the main goal was to kill someone named Lennox. And the ending of the game is also not really satisfying. It's just like, well, you killed Lennox, that was it. Thanks for playing. Even though I was playing on easy mode, I still found the game pretty difficult. Well, not the first missions, but the last two, the one on the bridge and the final level, were really difficult. And yeah, you can say I suck at the game, but as far as first person shooters go, I think I'm not that bad. I beat the campaign missions of Modern Warfare 1, 2, 3, Black Ops and World of War on veteran difficulty. So I wouldn't say that I'm that bad at first person shooters. Though I must say that I find the older first person shooters, like Half-Life or Timesplitters, a lot more difficult than the more recent first person shooters like Call of Duty or Battlefield. I think it might be because I find the controls a lot better in the newer first person shooters. I do find it harder to move around and aim in Black, as the controls feel a lot more stiff. A jump or sprint button is missing in Black. This doesn't ruin the game, it just makes it feel a lot slower. Moving from movement to enemies, the enemy placement or spawns seem a little unfair, especially with the final mission, where they just drop so many enemies that it's quite overwhelming. The enemies themselves look very similar, making it quite boring after a while to fight the same looking enemies over and over again. It also takes a lot of bullets to take them down, which is never a good thing. But as far as their behavior goes, they do a pretty good job. Evading grenades and or explosions, taking cover and putting pressure on the player. They actually move around and don't stay in one position, so it's always important to watch your back. Considering there aren't a lot of checkpoints within each mission, this can quickly make it really frustrating, because if you die, there's a chance you have to do 15 minutes of progress all over again. This isn't fun at all. When I can rush and cause chaos in Black, it's fun, like I could in the first few missions. But when I'm out of health packs and low on health, I am forced to take it slow and take out each enemy from far away. This isn't fun at all, especially since most weapons aren't that accurate from afar. Speaking of weapons, there's a lot of weapon variety. Assault rifles, submachine guns, shotguns, light machine guns, sniper rifles, an RPG, and a Magnum. But unfortunately, you can't carry all these weapons at the same time. You can only carry a maximum of two weapons. The sound the guns make is outstanding. It really makes me feel like I'm firing a gun. No, this game doesn't turn me into a murderer all of a sudden, it's just satisfying to fire the weapons in the game. Though the firing is very satisfying, the reloading of your weapons is not. Whenever you reload, your surroundings become blurry. I don't like this at all, especially if there's an enemy nearby. I like to know when an enemy is nearby so I can kill him as soon as I'm finished reloading. I also don't like the way you throw grenades. It seems your character is actually trying to throw the grenade at your feet. It's really hard to throw them far away, which is usually why I want to use them. To kill enemies too far away to hit precisely with a gun. I really don't know what the idea behind this weird grenade throw is. Maybe they wanted you to rely on your weapons, because that's where they seem to have put the most work in. The soundtrack of Black isn't that bad, but it isn't great either. I can't remember a single track from the game, but while playing it did give an extra feel to the game, so while not special, it's still an okay soundtrack. I mean, as long as it isn't annoying, it's all fine.
Copy that, Anvil 7-1. Right over watch for Echo 5-1, they're moving to Rally 1-2, brother.
Since the game doesn't have a multiplayer mode, there isn't really a reason to replay Black once you finish the story. I think the game could have really benefited from a co-op mode for the story mode in terms of replay value. I mean, it's always more fun to play games with friends. Overall, I would have to say I enjoyed playing Black, though I dragged on a bit too long. At first I really liked it, when I could just run around killing enemies. But as soon as I had to take it slow and shoot enemies from far away, the fun I had while playing was gone. At that point, I just wanted to finish the level as soon as possible. The sound design is amazing, though the soundtrack is just okay and the story is horrible. It is a fun game if you just want to shoot some enemies for like a half an hour, but any longer and it becomes boring pretty quickly. Unfortunately, there's just nothing memorable about any of these missions. If you like first-person shooters, I would recommend this game, just to see if it is something for you. If you don't like first-person shooters, you could still try it if what I mentioned sounds interesting. But if you want to try FPS, there are better options out there. But for a 6th-gen first-person shooter on a console, it's not that bad. Though it still came after Halo, so it could have done better. I don't think there's a lot of replay value on Black, at least for me there isn't, so I will not be playing it again. Black was a fun way to pass the time, but I will probably forget about most of the game in about a year. But if you had a great time while playing, that isn't necessary. Just enjoy the game.
Bravo here, I'm going in.
Negative, hold your position, Bravo.